D'accord, donc 2 secondes. All right, everyone, good evening, good evening, good evening. Welcome, welcome, welcome to yet another edition of The Marketplace with Uche Onochi. I welcome you all this evening. I hope your day's been good. I hope your weekend, we're just coming out of weekend. I hope that your weekend was good also. Welcome, welcome, guys. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Today we are dealing with something that's very important. You know, we say a lot of things, and this presentation has two parts. Today we're talking about how can I be in the right place at the right time? Can I manufacture that? Is it possible in any way that I can manufacture that? To be in the right place at the right time? Is it possible that I collide with this thing they call luck? What is it? Is it actually true? Am I supposed to rely on luck? Do I say I'm a lucky person? You know, so today we're going to find out these things that I'm talking about now, luck. Are you a lucky person? Are we lucky? Can I manufacture my own luck? Can I be in the right place at the right time continuously? Is it possible for me to do those things? So tonight we're going to find out if it's true. There are two parts of this presentation here today. There are two parts. The part is how can I begin to take action, more like action, take action for to take action for being in the right place at the right time to achieve my dreams. Can I use it to achieve my dreams? So it's quite an interesting topic, and I hope it's going to be worth your while. Just tune in, just sit back, and I will make out time if there's if you want to ask a question, please you can just put in my DM. Daniel, please help me be looking any questions. Let's interact. Let's just not talk, but also let's interact and see how I can answer one or two questions before I go. I would like that very much. It's the reason why I come here every Monday to do this. So I would like that very much. Okay, so I will just go into the presentation for the day. And that is how to be in the right place at the right time. Let me give you some overview. Why we are doing this. Have you ever wondered how some people seem to have all the luck? Oh, we say, well, I'm not lucky. Most of us would have said it at one time or the other in our life. I'm just not a lucky person. James is more lucky, is luckier than I. Patricia is luckier than I. I don't know why I have issues with luck. Some of us have said so, especially when we are not selected for something and we go there and things don't work out for us. I would say, I don't have luck. You know, I'm not a lucky person. But I keep telling people, you can manufacture your own luck. You can manufacture your own luck. Whether or not you believe in luck, there's something to be said for being in the right place at the right time. Some people believe it, some people don't. But be that as it may, there is something we can say concerning luck. And I want us to look at it tonight or this evening. For example, let me give you an example, an instance that can help you, to understand better what I'm talking about. Consider two people who got into a writing contest to win a cash prize of $1 million, for instance. you two writers, experienced writers. And in the course of that, we realized that one of the writers know enough about the topic to produce a satisfactory article in the given time and walks away with the prize. And some of us can say, okay, he was lucky. He was lucky because both of them are skilled. Both of them are skilled writers. They are not novice in that profession at all. So it's his lucky day, we might say, but it wasn't really luck. You cannot really, will you call it luck? They were both in the same place at the same time with the right skills to make the most out of the situation. Well, how come one got luckier than the other? One just happened to have the extra bit of information that allowed him to succeed while the other lost out. What am I saying here? The one that won is not a fluke. It's not a happenstance. It's not a fluke that he won. He just happened to have extra bit of information on his side. And this extra bit of information allowed him to succeed while the other guy lost out. You know, and so if some might say he was lucky, but let us really look. This presentation is to dissect the fact to see that, was he really lucky? Why did that happen? One simply had the right information at the right time, at the right place and at the right time, and he became lucky. So when we say you are lucky, three things happen. You have the right information, you are in the right place, and you are at the right time. And that is where you can become lucky. So what really, I say to people, you can manufacture your own luck. Your good luck, as well as the luck enjoyed by many successful people, can be attributed to three elements that I want to expose us to this evening. Can be attributed to three elements. So use these three elements to create your own luck, to manufacture your own luck, and stop saying that I'm not lucky, I don't have the right person, I don't know the right kind of people. You can indeed be able to manufacture your own luck or to create your own luck. And this is what, let's look at the elements of good luck. What are the elements of good luck as it regards to the example that I've showed you? The elements of good luck. One, the first one is proximity. Proximity. You know, you cannot catch fish without being near the water. No matter how skilled, no matter how wishful you are, no matter how much you pray, you cannot catch fish without being near the water. The people you think of as lucky often put a lot of effort in being near as many pertinent opportunities as possible. Lucky people are people that make sure they are close to opportunities as much as possible. You cannot be far from the people that you are looking to connect with. You must locate, and I always teach it, say it in, when I'm doing training, in your industry, in the market that you belong, all of us, we are selling something. So you must make sure that you are available. You make sure that you are close to things that are happening. If there's a seminar happening around you in your field, be there. If there's a party that around the people in your profession, be there. Don't say, no, I don't like those things. I don't like parties. I don't have time to go and socialize. See, if you don't socialize, it means that you are not getting close to the water. And if you're not getting close to the water, you cannot catch fish. Successful people know that proximity is the beginning of where you have opportunities that can help you scale. So put a lot, you guys on Instagram, put a lot of effort into being near as many pertinent opportunities as possible, because there you have a better chance. So it is not a fluke. Okay, from the example I gave you, they both had a shot at getting lucky because they weren't just two novices going into a contest. No, they were skilled writers looking at a writing opportunity. So they entered the contest to win a million naira, and they were skilled writers. They were both close to the opportunities, because sometimes you can be close to the opportunities, not just in skill or location, but in timing as well. Two of them had a lot in common, but we'll now see why one was able to excel over the other. They had the skills, they were in the right location, in the right timing. So you can put yourself in the right place at the right time more often by identifying an area which you have the necessary skills, knowledge to capitalize on sudden opportunities. The word here is sudden opportunities. Capitalizing on sudden opportunities. You must be there. And when you make sure not just go and be close to people or close to where opportunities are, you must have the right skill. You must know the location and the right timing. Like I say, successful people know how to make themselves available to be in places that matter. Someone asked me, so how do I know the events to go? How will I know the place? I say with time. With time, you will go. I say go to all events that you can. After a while, you will know which events matter. You will know who goes to what, who goes where in whatever event. And from there, you'll be able to say, you can deduce and say, this event will have this caliber of people. This is who I'm looking for. Everything must be based on what you want to achieve. It must be based on your goal. And you try as much as possible to be in the place where the people that matter to you, or the people that you know that will give you the chance, we give you the job, we give you the contract. And there, once you are there, it becomes easy for you to get those sudden opportunities. Ask yourself these questions. What are you doing to make timing right for you? What are you doing? You have to ask yourself. You must have the requisite skill. You must have the skill. You must have the skill. You not just have the skill, you must also now make the right. What are you doing to make timing right for you? Like I said, visit every event that you feel is useful until you are able to identify the ones that really matter for you. What area have you put yourself in a position to get lucky? So now you are in a position to get lucky by having knowledge. In the two guys I mentioned, one of them had more information than the other guy. So you see that the other guy was also a skilled writer, but he did not have enough information. His problem was information. He did not have enough information to get lucky. So you cannot be lucky everywhere. But you see, when that opportunity comes in that area where you are skilled and gifted, please make sure that you kill it. If you're a preacher, a motivational speaker, and all that, I've happened to be in a place and somebody just recognized me and told the convener that I was there. And the convener said, that I need to take a topic. That, in fact, they will have a second lecture. And they asked the people in the crowd, would they like to hear from me? And they said, yes. And they were talking about a topic that I liked. They were talking about a topic I have researched, I have taught many times. And by the time I finished speaking, everybody lined up to want to get my contact or one or the other, or one detail or the other from me. Why was it so? You know, it looked as if I got lucky. But the luck was not there. The luck was, I was already prepared in that topic. Just like the guy that won. Assuming now, the guy said, let's have a contest between me and somebody else. And there was going to be a cash prize of 500,000. From the reaction of the crowd, I would have gotten the money. Why? Because I was already prepared. So you must be prepared in your own area. If it wasn't my area, I would have politely declined so that I will not go there and make a fool of myself. Anytime you are not prepared, I will advise you that you politely decline. Decline the offer. Don't say it's an opportunity for me to talk. When you know that you cannot hit it, you cannot kill it, then please, maybe you should go and get prepared. Because what it means is that you never know where you are going to speak. You never know with whom you are going to speak, where you're going to speak, where you're going to sell, where you're going to show that your skill or show what you have. You never know where. So you must be prepared. You must be prepared. If you sell something, you have something to sell, you're a salesperson, you must be practicing your pitch every day. When I was in sales, we were taught to practice our pitch every day to both difficult people, to both male and female, young and old. We had pitch for people 60 and above. We have pitch for people between 40 and 45. We have pitch for people 35 under. We have pitch for people between 20 and 30. So when opportunity comes for you to sell that, you know how you sell to a 20-year-old. You know how to position yourself to sell to a 60-year-old because you have rehearsed the pitch before. You have. So ask yourself the question, what, in which area can I be lucky? In which area can you be lucky? It means that in which area have you developed yourself? And when that opportunity comes, kill it. Is there a skill that you need to improve? So if I go now, I listen, I go to a church, I go somewhere, I go to a seminar, and I listen to a topic. And I see that this topic is trending. Then it means that I need to take time to go and become knowledgeable, gain knowledge in that topic. So when I'm called to speak, I will maximize the opportunity. So you need to find your, always look out, is there a skill I can improve on or knowledge you can gain that will allow you to better capitalize on opportunities you discover? So what I am saying is that you need as much as possible, you need to develop yourself, your skills, develop yourself. In your area, for me, every day I have to listen, not fully, for 10 minutes, for at least 5 minutes, 10 minutes, depending on the speaker. I go, there are some people, I will just go and listen to them for 5-10 minutes. What is the topic they are discussing in the marketplace today? If I see those topics that are trending, and I will develop my skills in that. Because you never know when they're going to call you to speak, and you have enough knowledge in that particular area. So now you can call me to speak and I can speak within 5 minutes. I can tell you, oh, I'm up, I can be up in 5 minutes. It's because I have prepared for it. And that is how you can create your own luck. Okay. Another, I called it the element of good luck. Another element of good luck is practice. The fish not caught on the first day, on the first try, is larger when you finally catch it. So if you miss something, what am I saying by that? If you miss something today, I think if you miss something today, It does not mean that you are not able to catch. If you miss a fish today, catching a fish today, it does not mean that tomorrow you'll not be able to catch that same fish. What is happening, the fish will be growing bigger, waiting for you. So go and develop, go and practice that thing that you want to do. Practice it so that by the time you come back, you have become an expert in it. Ask any professional athlete about a shining moment in their athletic experience. They will tell you that luck came only after long hours of practice. Luck came after long hours of practice. What do I mean by that? For you to be lucky, we are discussing on the element of good luck. It means that luck comes only after long hours of practice. Then you can say this athlete was lucky. And you just see a new kid on the block. You just see a new athlete just come out. And I say, he's lucky. Can you imagine? And he just won. Maybe something happened to the last champion and this one came. To you, it's luck. It's not luck. That guy has been training for years. To go to the Olympics, you have to train for 4 years. Or in fact, you have to train for maybe 15, 18 years before you have the opportunity. So when you get there, you'll be able to make it. So these are the things. There's really nothing like luck. Luck comes with hard work. Luck comes after long hours of practice. It comes with practice. How about in basketball, for you to get a three-pointer, you will admire them. You admire them from they are getting 3-pointers and they're getting 3 points and they are showing from outside the circumference, that semi-circumference that they have in basketball. If you watch it, you see that they are making that 3-pointers. They are showing. And to you, it looks as if they are lucky. It's not luck. They are putting more than 1,000, more than 10,000 hours of that free throw they've been showing, and that's why it looks as if they are lucky. To you, you can say, oh, this guy is always lucky. From any angle, he's getting it. He's just lucky. But it's not luck. It's practice. A web designer creates hundreds of applications before bringing the perfect one to market. In every case, practice that precedes the instance of luck is just as important as crowning moment where people say that you are lucky. So practice not only makes perfect, practice also brings good luck. Practice also makes you lucky, look lucky. So let me leave you with also some questions as it regards practice. You know, questions that will help you to start your journey and say, look, I also want to be lucky. I also want to be in the right place at the right time. I want to create my own luck. You know, ask yourself these questions. Have you given up on practice only to wonder why you are not improving in your field and experiencing the same luck as others? You might say a colleague is getting a lot of breaks in the office. It's because he has not quit practicing. And some practice, even when you were successful last year, and now you are not successful. And some people, they will just begin to rest, you know, they just begin to slow down a bit, and they find out that they are no longer as lucky as they used to. It's because they are no longer practicing as they used to. They are no longer practicing, they are no longer putting in hours that matter, that can create that luck. What steps can you take today in order to hone your senses and polish your skills, waiting for the next opportunity that can be turned into a lucky moment? So develop, make sure you are improving every day. When I see somebody that is improving every day, is somebody that wants to be lucky all the time. Luck comes with practice. Luck comes with doing the same. Luck comes with rehearsing, improving yourself in what you do. And the once you improve yourself and practice more, I tell you, be more lucky. The areas that it looks as if you are more lucky, you are luckier than others, is the area that you have taken out time to build yourself. Okay, the third element of love is persistence.
So,
one sad truth of existence is that most people give up before they should. Most people give up even before making out time. You know, they give up without even putting the best, their best. I don't think there's any successful person that has not thought about abandoning what they are doing to try something else. There was a time, this marketplace apostle thing that I'm doing every week, sometimes it can be two times a week, I just want to drop it and do something else. You know, I feel that a lot of people feel that way. But do you give up? If you give up, you will not find that love. As people say, being in the right place at the right time involves being in a lot of places at a lot of times that might seem inconvenient and even painful. Before you can, somebody will just say you are lucky. Oh, he was there at the right time. You know, he was in the right place at the right time. What they don't understand is that you come there every day. So that day you collided with luck that same day, not because it was your first time. So you can put yourself in a situation, in a position that you can place that luck for yourself. You've heard that luck favors the well-prepared. Let luck favors the well-prepared. No, you prepares, but that this guy. Look at this. All right. So we've had that luck favors the well prepared, but what about luck favoring the tenacious? Luck favors the well prepared. I've talked about that. But luck also favors the tenacious. Every successful person I know have come close to giving up and saying, they look failure directly in the eyes and they say, no, not yet. Let me give it one more try. And most of the time, you become lucky when you just say, let me give it one more try. Even in our social life, even in looking for spouses, some people almost gave up, but just said, let me just try one more time. And that was now what seemed like their lucky moment. There's nothing like love. You create and manufacture your own love. You know, so sometimes it looks like the successful people are closed, have had closed business, they've lost clients. They've left relationship, but they never stop trying. They never give up. People that do not meet up, people that are not lucky, are people that give up on time. Okay, so still talking about being persistent. Do you have a tendency? This is the question. The questions I'm asking is the questions that can help you, you know, provoke you to be able to ask yourself these questions and say, look, I want this element of love to work for me. Do you have a tendency to give up on things too easily or too early? Some people just feel, I don't have energy. I have a lot of people. I'm someone that used to hang around me and I had to stop that person from saying, I don't have energy. You know, I don't have energy for this type of thing. I don't have energy for this type of, and once you keep saying, I don't have energy for this type of thing, you will not have the stamina to go go and get it. I don't have energy for this. Or some people will say, I cannot come and kill myself. You know, and you know, so once you try something, you try it again. After a while, some people tend to like, let me try something else. But you don't know that maybe it's in the next thing, you know, just giving it one more try is where you can become successful and people say you are lucky. Think of the last project you gave up. Maybe if you had stayed longer, it would have been possible. What might have happened that you stuck to that same project? Maybe you would have been successful. Maybe you would have been richer than you are today. Are you currently giving everything to the project or relationship you have at hand? You know, or not saying that, oh, I don't have energy, I don't have this. Have you ever wondered why some people seem to have all the luck? Luck can be manufactured by paying close attention to your proximity, of which I've said, and to opportunities, making sure you are available, following through with practice and persistence, you find out that you have become a lucky person. Proximity, being there at the right time. Not being there at the right time, make sure you are in close proximity to whatever you want. In whatever field, you are close by. And you are practicing your pitch. You are practicing in that area continuously. And you are persistent and say, no, I will not give up. What will you realize is that you realize that after a while, you will become lucky like others. So now is, when is the right time to take action, to act on your dreams? A lot of young men, and not just young men, ask me a lot of these questions. When is the right time for me to take, when is the right time for me to act on my dreams? And some will tell you, I've been praying. I've been praying and I'm not getting any leading. God is not saying anything. So they are waiting 2 years, they are waiting 3 years, they are waiting 4 years, they are waiting. Sometimes trusting our dreams takes courage. Because if your dream is something you can achieve by your own power, then it means it's not your dream at all. If it's a dream, it's something you can achieve, you set a target, you achieve it, then that is not a dream. That is not something you should focus. A lot of us want to wait for the right time to take action, but there is never a right time. There's never a right time to get married. There's never a right time to buy land. There's never a right time to build a house. There's never a right time to look for a job. There's never a right time to start business. Anytime you start, that is the right time. We wait for more money. Oh, I need more money. I need more clarity. I need more sign from God for me to start. But waiting is what prevents us from getting what we want. The more that we wait, it prevents us from getting what we want. Are you waiting for the right time to act? Please stop. There's no right time to act. And so let me give you some reminders today that can help you to make sure that you act now. The time is now for you to act. There's nothing like right time. So let me give you some tips that can help you to start your journey in doing what you want to do. The first one is create the right time. You create the right time yourself. Most of us wait for the right time and the right time never comes. We keep waiting for the perfect moment, but the waiting keeps us stuck. When you are waiting and you keep waiting, you are stuck. You are stuck. And sometimes, you know, I shared it in one group where I was, and I said, God deals with us in different ways. Some people, they want to do something, they pray, they wait, they pray and they wait for God to give them a sign or to speak to them and so they can move forward. Yes, for some people, it works. For me, it has worked for me. But it depends on you. It has worked for me that I pray, but most of the time, I'm praying and believing God, and God is just watching me. Now, I use this words a lot, like a slogan, when you do nothing, God does nothing, because it's a personal experience for me. When you do nothing, God does nothing. And so sometimes God wants you to take the initiative, because that is faith. Does God, let me say it again, is he waiting on God to make a move? Is it right? Yes, it is right. But there's times also God expects you to make a move. God can use that to train you. He has used that in my own training to train me. And God does what? I prayed for 2 years before starting making Nigeria. I didn't get anything. I didn't hear any word. I didn't hear anything. And I could have still been praying and I've not heard anything, but I decided to move. And once I made that move, By faith, God started speaking to me. The day I started, there was no money for me to be able to do a conference and exhibition that extent. But there was absolutely no money at that time. But if I had waited, I would not be able to be talking about the 11th edition now this year. It would not have been possible. So sometimes faith, God answers your questions, gives you an answer on the go. It gives you an answer on the go once you make that, because that is faith. Faith is the currency of heaven. When you make that move, it becomes the right time. When is the right time to get married? When you decide is the right time. Recognize you actually create the right time by doing what? Aligning with what you want. By the way, it's God that put that thing inside of you. Because the Bible tells me that he's the one that maketh us both to will and to do his good pleasures. So some of the things that you think is your thought is God that put it inside. Instead of waiting for the perfect moment, which will never come, focus on what you want. Set a date. Start saving towards it. Work towards it. Have a plan. And you will see that it becomes easier for you. The right time is your time. You create your reality and you create your own time. And like I was saying about making Nigeria, I made the move. And if it was not the will of God, it would not have been this much. Marketplace Apostle was also something I did. I said, no, God, this is what I wanted to do. Today, it is a success. But it's been 18 years and God's been helping us. If there was no right time, the time I was supposed to marry was not the right time. But as I decided that I wanted to, God, you see, once a man makes up his mind to do something, men and the elements of creation will help you. God has already put it in place. Not only heavens, the earth will help you. Men will help you. Things will begin to fall into place. Once you are determined, once you are focused for something, everything will begin to fall into place for you after a while. If you persist, when you are intentional, you want to start a business, that is when you don't have money. When I want to buy land, that is when something came and money was hanging. When I wanted to build, something will happen. And you something that is normal or every day is okay, but once you decide something, the everywhere will block. Why? Because those things are there to make you not make a move. I have friends that are just getting married because they were waiting for the right time. And now they see they can't wait any longer because the tummy has become so big. Anywhere they go, they're asking their aunt, madam. And out of shame, now they have to go and do it because they were waiting for the perfect time where the money is in place. The right time is where you decide is the right time. And I tell people, I say, look, for me, I know that if I start, you know, and people are scared. Well, people are always scared that what if I start it? It's not the will of God. It's not going to work and all that. This leads me to my the next point I want to give concerning the right time for you to act. Nothing is permanent. There are very few things that are permanent. But in terms of business and in life, it can change. One is that permanent, God is permanent in your life. And when you get married, well, you've gotten married. You say you are going to marry this person. You've gotten married. That is permanent in your life. But when it comes to business, you can change methodology. It's your vision that is not going to change. When it comes to starting an organization, when it comes to making plans, setting plans, it can change. Plans change. Many of us feel paralyzed by the choices we make, because we worry about taking action one way and or another will be permanent. Say that when I start this business, it's permanent. When I start working here, it's permanent. The only thing that I'll tell you is permanent is that you can't be changing spouses. But apart, because now you have, it has to do with somebody else. It has to do with a human being. And you have no right to play with somebody's life and destiny. But is it business? You can change business. You can change plans. Your vision for your life, it should be, is what is cast on stone. Your vision, not your mission statement. Not your methodology can change. We think things like, what if we go out and it doesn't work? That means you are afraid of failure. You get stuck. Successful people are people that are not afraid of failure. Because really, failure is a pointer to success. Failure tells you that this thing you tried didn't work. Maybe you need to change. You need to change style and model. Because if you've not failed before, most of the time, you will not appreciate, not only appreciate success, but you will not even know how to get there. Failure is telling you, no, you didn't get it right. Try it again. Recognize every choice you make is an opportunity to learn more about yourself and to grow. Don't be afraid. Not everything is permanent. I've seen people that went to read. I've seen someone that I've read, went to read engineering and came out and said, I never wanted to do sciences. I've always wanted to read history. If you ask me, as I speak today, we are friends because as I speak today, I just wanted to, if you had left me, is history, I would have read English, I would have read history because I like history, archaeology, that's what I would have loved to read though. And there's nothing stopping you from making a change and going back to what you want to do as long as you have life. Don't be afraid. Once you're afraid that, oh, if I make this decision now, it's permanent. As long as it has nothing to do with marriage, it has nothing to do with your faith. Any other thing can change as long as you have an idea of what you want. Every choice is only a choice. It's just a choice. Do you know how many times, I think it's Thomas Edison that who did the electric bulb? Is it Edison? He failed 999 times. And they asked him what he said that it was 999 steps before he got it right. So you see how he coined it? It's just a choice. We made this, it didn't work. Try again, try something else. You can make a new choice again and again and again at any point until you get it right. Because you didn't get it right the first time, some people will pack it up and go and say, no, it was not the right time. Maybe I launched out too early. No, you are just going through the learning curves. You are not, and you know, I don't know why people feel that they will just come into something. Business, they've never done business before, and they'll just come into business and everything is smooth sailing. But things don't work that way. Things don't usually work that way. You have to be what? You have to be close, proximity, practice, and persistence brings luck and brings success. Okay, so another point in for you to be at the right time, at the right place, at the right time to act on your dreams is you are always being guided. God has given us all that pertains to life and godliness. If you understand, somebody told me this thing more than 30 years ago and he helped me. You are not alone. When we say we are not alone physically, spiritually, we are never alone. You have angels that are assigned to you. They are dormant because you don't understand. The whole earth moves in your favor. When you focus on a dream and set your intentions, the universe will come in to support you. God gave us the law of attraction to attract the things that is uppermost in our minds. God also gave us the power of the subconscious mind to attract what we want into our lives. You are never alone. You can attract the right kind of people into your life if you understand the laws of gravity, the laws of attraction. God created the earth and put laws, put principles to govern it. There's a law of gravity that when you throw something up, it comes down. There's a law of wealth and prosperity. It is universal. Whether you serve God or not, when you apply the laws, the natural laws of prosperity, you will be rich. The same thing applies. When you apply the laws of attraction, you will attract good things to you. You are never alone. If you understand the law of 6 degrees of separation, it says that you have 4 to 6 people already in your life that can take you to wherever you want to. It's a law. It's a law. You are never alone. You are never alone. You think you are alone. You are never alone. God is a good father. And he has given you all that pertains to life and godliness. You are feeling alone because you want to throw that pity party for yourself alone. Once you are intentional about it, let me tell you. You see, I wish I can get married now. I will block everywhere and bring. I'm just waiting for 20 years in marriage. It's not long. I'm going to do, what do they call it? Renewal of vows. So that I can shame the devil for what he did to me before my marriage. Do you understand? But as soon as I decided, that I was going to get married, we started. There was not money. There was never even enough money now. There was a relative, the most stingy relative I've known. He was rich, but he never gives people something. I called him, I went to see him. He gave me 200,000. But trust those type of people. They don't give you all at once. He gave me just a few days to the wedding. And I was saying that, is it now that I needed it? But I thank God that I had something to use afterwards. To get a flat, I had the house that I just put rug inside. But someone paid for 2 years for that for me. There were some kind of favor that came as soon as I decided. You know what happened to me there? The universe helped me. As I decided, the law of attraction, I was thinking about it. I was attracting good things into my life. You can attract goodness. The universe can nudge you. People say the universe nudges you in your heart, or they'll say intuition. That's what the world calls it, but I call it the Holy Spirit. Because Jesus, that is going to in John 16, verse 7, he said, let me go, I'll send you a comforter. And this comforter, in now verse 16, he said, he will guide you into all truth. John 16, 13, he said he will guide you into all truth. He will tell you of what the Father is saying, and he will even tell you of the future. So you are not alone. That nudge you are having, or some people say something, I felt like that, something told me. No, what do people say? It's like something told me, or it's like something, guys, help me out. What? It's like I had this feeling of, my mind told me or something. It's not your mind. It's the Holy Spirit telling you if you understand it. It's important to trust yourself and the guidance that you receive. The day I realized that I'm not alone, that God has given me angels and things to help me, He helped me get through my singlehood. You know, especially for Lagos ladies, they feel that if they are single, that is the end of the world. But you are not alone. You are single physically, but spiritually, you are not. You are fully engaged. And you can attract those things. Listen to my courses on the subconscious mind. You know, I mentor a lot of people on that. You can ask me on Wednesdays. Also, some people, I coach some people. And some people have said, look, which I need you to coach me for a while on this law of attraction and subconscious mind. I coach people on that. And I'm going to talk about it at the end of the day. So it is something we need to understand. You know, give it a go. What goal do you want to realize? Once you say, this is the goal I want to realize, things will help you. Then what steps do I need to take? Write those steps down. It's not, oh, I want to be rich and you are, there's no plan towards it. There must be, this is where I am. This is where I'm going. I need to get there. So you need to have a plan. Then once you have a plan, then start. Start doing it. Okay. All right. I've almost come to the end of my presentation today, but I just want to let you guys know the things that we do in Marketplace Apostles. For you guys on Facebook, welcome. And on Instagram, I see Collins, I see you, welcome. I see you on Facebook. I can't see the other person, the other people, but I see Bobby on Instagram. I see Ewolo on Instagram. You guys, welcome. I see Emmy. I see Emmy Bestwear. I see you guys. Welcome to our teaching today. I always try to say as much as possible to let you guys know what we do here. Marketplace Apostle is an organization that is committed to equipping men and women with principles for success in five areas. Five areas: career, business, leadership, personal finance, and relationships. As it regards relationship, as it regards marriage, corporate relationships, personal relationships, and interpersonal skills. This is what we teach. We call it our fivefold ministry, but it's not like what the one that is in the Bible, but this is the five areas of our focus. So every Monday, you can see that I take topics within those five areas. And on Wednesday by 4 p.m., Wednesday by 4 p.m., I come to do my mentoring, my free mentoring session. And in the free mentoring, session, people ask me questions from all over the world. It's by 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. every Wednesday, 1 hour. People ask me questions, and I come within that hour to answer them. So the questions can come in these five areas and life issues. I'm also a certified life coach. So now people can ask me questions and I will answer them. People can ask me questions and I will answer them. Those is my mentoring session is for free. Today is for free. This is the CSR that we do from here. Is where we started this thing during the lockdown. And so during the lockdown, I started mentoring and doing this Monday marketplace with Uchonoche. Yes. So I'm doing that, and there's been quite a lot of testimony. I get a lot of people writing it and saying, this has helped me. Someone wanted to commit suicide, got a word, and from our mentoring, people's businesses have been transformed from what we do here. So it is a great thing for us to do this thing. So please, I just need you to just help us. And when you get the alert or see us, follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, even on LinkedIn, we are there and we promote all our activities. Just help us like it so you get the information and send it to someone that can join us next week. This is all I ask. This is the fees that you need to pay to us. To just help us send it out there. And for those of you, if you want the slides, I teach with slides. If you want to go through with the slides, then you can come on Zoom. Every advert on Facebook, on social media has a Zoom link. So you can use that and meet me up in Zoom if you're interested in the in my slides. Also, I have materials. I have a lot of materials. And Uche Onoche, if you go to ucheonoche.com, you will see I have ebooks there. I have audio there. They are cheap. I have courses there. I have videos there. And they are seriously discounted. Some of these things that I teach, you can get them there on ucheonoche.com. Okay. I have a mentoring outfit. A coaching outfit. The mentoring that I do is free, but the coaching is not. People that feel that they need a deeper work, like somebody has approached me, or people approach me, this subconscious mind and law of attraction, I needed to use it to change my life. And people have approached me, that is a paid event. And people have approached me, I said, okay, that we need to get a contract to do that for a period of time. If you are interested, then you can put it out in our DM. But if not, you can't afford it, then you can also ask me any question that you want on Wednesday. I'll also be glad to do that for you. Then I want to introduce our annual event, Making Nigeria. Making Nigeria is the largest business exhibition and conference in the south and southeast of Nigeria. And this year we are doing the 11th edition. And the theme for this year is building sustainable businesses. It's going to run from 7th to 9th of October 2021. We're going to be live on all the social media handles. This year is going to be virtual. Not physical, but we're trying to see how we can bring in a selling platform that can work for the exhibition. So if you keep in touch, you will see the adverts have started coming out. You can start registering. It's going to be awesome. We have great speakers that are coming to be speaking this year from different places. So please tune in and just keep being informed. I will begin to after a while, we'll introduce the speakers. So just register towards it. You will soon see the advert. Okay, so these are some of the informations that I have for you. Like I said, on Wednesday, I come for my mentoring session. Ask me anything. The beauty of it is that people ask questions and they don't put their name. They just put Uche O. From what you help us do is from where are you calling or where are you writing from, want to know which country. And we've had from US, we've had from all over the world asking a question, and this question has helped a lot of people. A young man, well, the ideology he had was broken and he has helped him as a business person because he had some certain mindset that was changed. And this mindset has helped him, has freed him here. And like I said, the counsel we give you have saved someone from committing suicide. So there's a lot that is happening in this council. Don't keep quiet. Black people, we need counsel and we need advice. And in the multitude of counselors, there's safety. So I hope to see you on Wednesday. I hope to see you on Monday also. And I also hope to see you. I hope that you register. I want you to register for Make in Nigeria 2021. All right, God bless you guys. I hope to see you guys on Wednesday. Have a great night and God bless you. Good night.